Hi, this is Colin Young. He's from San Diego, but where are you going to school?
I go to Carleton College in Northfield, Minnesota.
Northfield, Minnesota. Cold country?
It is, yeah, indeed. Yeah.
Well, Colin is here in Santa Barbara with me, and we've been talking about the use of a UV light, a black light, in evaluating artwork. And I wanted him to tell you what his thoughts were about how important this information and this technology is for art history students to know before they get into the real world or the work world. So how did our lesson go for you, and how important is it, do you see, for art history students?
Well, I mean, I think for anyone interested in art in any capacity, it's essential to be able to understand the use of a black light so that you can speak intelligently and with knowledge about the condition of a painting and what has gone through. Specifically, we talked about insurance claims and pre-existing conditions as sort of a buzzword. But, you know, this application for the black light extends across all areas of art. You know, you have museums, you need to check the condition of the paintings. For individual collectors wanting to buy and make sure the paintings are up to par, for dealers who are trying to buy at auction, and even for auctioneers themselves to make sure they're putting out a product that's not fraudulent or damaged prior to.
Essentially, you know, a UV light is part of risk management. A museum would inspect a painting that is maybe on loan, coming in for an exhibition, and they would want to use a UV light to see if there are previous restorations to make sure the painting is what it says it is. Or an auction house obviously doesn't want to sell a painting that they think is in perfect condition when actually there's been touch-up and other restorations done. Or you as a collector, obviously, would not pay the same for a painting with a lot of retouching on it, and you wouldn't pay the same as a painting that's in virgin condition, right?
Correct.
So all of that, those things, and reports and knowing the real condition, this UV light, I think it's essential. Has it hit you as being the same way?
Yeah, it has. And I mean, we talked a little bit about the difference between one black light that cost about $80 or $90 and then one that was superior and cost $400. And when you look at it from that standpoint, you say, oh, you know, it's $300. It's kind of a big difference, big margin. But when you apply that over a lifetime of the ability to check out exactly what's wrong with the painting, that $300 will be made up pretty quickly.
Well, there's a lot more knowledge that you can get from a $400 light, and of course all you need to do is one good deal, one good purchase and resale, and make the money, and that one upgrade will be paid for 1,000 times. Well, thanks a lot, appreciate you telling us your impressions, and good luck in your collecting. He's young looking, besides his last name being Young, but he is already on the road to being a great collector, and I've enjoyed talking with him a lot over the years about his purchases and paintings that he's evaluating. So he's not just talking to you from a theoretical point of view, he's talking to you because he's in the game and on the hunt and looking at artwork.
Yeah? Yeah.
Okay, thanks.